Greg Brown.
And I'm David Ivey. This is Dynamic Discussions.
This week, along with every week, we have Kaylee Lang from our marketing department, and she has a question.
The question for this week is, when should I use a leading edge self-retracting lifeline instead of a standard self-retracting lifeline?
That's a great question, one that gets asked to us a lot, at least a dozen times a week. And it's a very important question. It's also important to know what self-retracting lifelines do and when you should use the different classes and different variations of those.
So we have a couple self-retracting lifelines here with us today. There's many different types. So you have some that are mounted overhead, some you wear on your back, some that are leading edge, some that are for overhead use only, class A, class B. Some that have internal rescue capabilities, they have a winch built in. So it's very important to know when to use which style of self-retracting device.
Some of our examples that we have, this is our hybrid hog part number C6001. This is a dual class self-retracting device. It's a 30 foot. And so it's got braided steel cable. This one is used for overhead fall protection only, for fall arrest. We've got our handle here. And as you can see, the cable comes out of the housing, and like most self-retracting lifelines, it's on a spring. And then if you would have a fall, it stops and then dissipates your force as well. These are only used for overhead where you cannot come in contact with any leading edges, which is a surface below, something that the cable can come in contact with and possibly shear or not arrest your fall properly.
So here we have an example of a leading edge self-retracting lifeline. So what this means is that this unit has been tested to come in contact with the edge. So you can use this at foot level, overhead, anywhere that the cable has the possibility to come in contact with the edge. So we have this shock pack on here. What this does is that it gives an additional energy absorption device. So when you, if you were to fall over an edge, it will help reduce the forces on the body.
Yeah, so what you'll think is, okay, we have a shock pack here. So what this is, it's woven fabric, and it's sewn together in a way that if a fall occurs, when you have your braking mechanism of your lifeline, that this will shred down and provide your dissipation of your fall, where this, all that stuff happens internally. So that's why it's important that you don't come into contact with an edge with this line. Not only could your line shear, but it could arrest your fall improperly, and that could really hurt you as well. It's also important to know that not every self-retracting lifeline with a shock pack below the housing is leading edge. Us, for example, we have our small Pygmy Hog series. Those are class A self-retracting devices, and the shock pack is external, but it is not a leading edge.
So one of the big things is so looking at this, you technically cannot tell that this is a leading edge device. So you want to look at the label, and it'll call out SRL-LE, and that tells you that's a leading edge device.
It's a very good idea to speak to your employer to make sure that this is written into your fall protection plan and you have the proper equipment for each job. If you have any questions, I know that most manufacturers have everything right on the label and it's very easy to get a hold of your local rep or your warehouse or something like that.